It's hey tables, what's up?
And tablets.
You know what?
You might
a table is one gender together.
You might know us as Juicy Jake, the Sacred Demon,
Blanket Bitch.
Harpo, Car Cat, and Fra Batman. You can't really see me, but
hey.
But right now we were. What the hell did you do?
I didn't do anything. It's still recording. Calm
your
tits.
Oh, okay.
Jesus Christ, JJ.
I just moved the mouse. Calm down.
But right now, we are at a sleepover. Should we tell them where we are?
No.
We're in Kansas.
We don't have to tell them the exact address. We can tell them what state, though.
City, state, whatever.
No, say state.
We can tell them which
just say
state.
Let's say state.
Don't you start with me.
There's a million
dude, no, we can say city because there's enough people in this city to where we can still be hidden.
Fine.
So we're in Denver, Colorado right now.
No, there's another Denver somewhere else.
We're not in LA where all the big YouTubers are from.
I wish.
We'll be there in 4 years.
Yeah. Once we graduate.
Pinky.
We're not gonna explode, Gil. Calm down.
No, we're gonna explode. Anyway, we've started this video so we can rant because we were planning on doing this for how long?
God damn it, Sacred Demon!
Calm your tits! But we were planning on doing this for the longest time and we finally got to it.
Because this is a
big... Do you realize how loud that is? It's gonna overpower us.
Yeah, dude, shut it off.
I'm not shutting it off, I'm turning it down.
Okay.
So.
Oh, God.
We're here.
Yeah. No.
To rant.
You start.
JJ, you start.
Sacred Demon.
Okay, so fine. We got this bitch in school and she is a complete and utter whore. And we are all so sick of her. It is not even funny. Like, every single time we see her, we get so pissed off. And I'm the only one that talks to her still because I'm, like, medium with everything. And it freaking sucks because, like, I'm sitting there and she's horrible at drawing. Horrible. Like, I never criticize anyone's drawing, but goddamn.
It is.
And I thought I was bad.
Just to make the argument a little more vague, we're just tying it up.
You can't see us very well anyways.
The only one you can really see is that one.
Is you.
These. Okay.
Dude, calm
you
down.
See a random face in the background.
She looks like a hippie.
Grudge.
Thank you. Anyway.
Yeah, she has the longest hair here, by the way.
Anyway, continuing.
Just to make the argument a little more vague, I think all of us can agree that we're mainly ranting about... Not that.
Oh, my God.
Not that. Although that was funny.
That I had to release that.
Anyways.
What does it look like the demon inside you?
Anyways, just to make the argument just a little bit more vague, we're just tired of guys and or girls wasting their time on people who really couldn't care either way.
Okay, so I'm gonna say this, and I'm gonna say this now, cause it's really legit. And so for all you girls out there that go for those swag fags, just stop. Go for a guy that sets goals and makes achievements, and has an education, because in 10 years from now, swag ain't gonna pay the bills.
Also,
hurry up and edge up one.
Make sure he dresses good.
Shut up, Miss Californian.
Mister.
Mister. No, it's Mrs. It's Mrs. now.
I said Mister California.
Mister.
Mister.
Mister. Excuse me.
Watch me.
I want my $50 right now.
I'm gonna go.
Give me my $50.
I'm gonna go California.
$50 right now. No, I'm joking.
Fine. Here's your $50.
Oh hell yeah! No, I'm joking.
What are you gonna do? Borrow fucking Bradley's clothes?
No, I have my own clothes.
I know.
Can I please speak?
Yes.
No.
Let him talk.
I can stop this recording whenever I want to. Don't make me turn this recording around!
I got my tablet.
Bitches.
I got the mouse.
Oh, I like the song. Oh, no. I like the song. The song is that dialogue.
Anyway. Oh, calm your titties. Anyway.
I like this song.
Anyway.
Fine, we'll put it back here.
Thank you. Anyway, goddamn.
Jesus.
This whore went for one of my best friends, and I'm like... Fucking nasty. No, she's been around the block so many times. To compare her vagina to something like in our lives, we compare a hallway and a hot dog.
No, honey.
She's a high school hallway.
No, honey.
The band hallway?
Yeah.
Yes, we're all band geeks, except for these two.
Honey. She's like a light switch everyone can turn her on.
She's like a hardware store, 10 cents a screw.
She's like a doorknob, everyone gets a turn.
Oh. Her vagina is like a saying, they she's come like and they go.
She's like a cake, everyone gets a piece of her.
Telling high school students to watch their language is like telling the whore to stay sterile.
Telling high school students to watch their language is like telling teachers to actually teach.
Miss Bristol.
Okay. In my words, it's like trying to pick up an overcooked little piece of ramen noodle with an empty Pringles can.
It's so nasty.
It's like, whoop, and then just like,
whoop. It's like overcooked hamburger.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh god, no.
No.
Overcooked first cup. No, no, no. The first cup she got was one of those split open hot dogs.
Stop it. God, you're sleeping haunted outside.
God.
So. Are we done with this video?
No.
Fuck no. Dude,
we got so much to talk about, it ain't even funny. We'll stop at, We'll stop at like 30 minutes at most.
Okay.
15 at least.
Okay,
math.
So
and then we got this bitch all up in math.
Hold up.
Talk loud.
Math teachers.
Speak from your diaphragm.
Who think they're teaching something, but they're really not.
Okay, so the math teacher we have is a math teacher is a fucking lunatic. She's loony. Okay, she's like 1, 2, 6, 4. What the fuck are you doing? Do you remember that? 1, 2, 6, 4.
And then she did that in third hour once.
And then she's like, oh, and then I'm like, hey, miss, I have a question. And she's like, okay, honey. Miss, I have a question. I'll get to you in a minute.
See, and like, what's weird about our math teacher?
2 seconds later.
Yeah.
Next video we no, do like what's... this. I have a video camera downstairs. You can record off of that.
What?
No, do you guys want my logic?
No. What's weird about our math teacher, because I know where you're going with this, so, and that's where the same place where I was going.
Maybe.
You ask her what the square root of 25 is, and her answer, well, the meaning of life is.
So basically she answers everything else but the question.
And
that
then
you
as
have.
Soon as you start to argue, she's like, I don't want to argue with you, go in the hall. And she does it, she only does it to the black people in our class.
Yeah, dude, she is so racist.
And we're in Colorado. We're not in Alabama.
We're not in Georgia. No, Georgia's awesome.
Georgia's awesome. Don't make fun of Georgia.
Don't make fun of Michigan.
Detroit is sucks.
Excuse me.
Okay, we all
agree. Detroit Rock City, motherfucker.
So if you guys want the whole rundown, it's like, hey, miss, what's the square root of 25? Well, the meaning of life is. Then she goes through this whole conversation.
Okay. Speak up more.
We need background music for this. Like, very faint. I'm talking about in the recording.
When you try and answer her back, trying to reason with her, she's just like, well, we've been learning about this for a couple of weeks now, you should know it. And then you're just like, well, I still don't know. And then the last thing she probably would say to you is, I'm not going to argue with you. Go out in the hallway. I'll talk to you later.
And then then she leaves you out there the entire class period.
Oh, God, no, our German teacher, Indie Schrunk.
Yeah, that is punishment in German class for us. Oh, Indie Schrunk.
Don't get us even started on our English teacher.
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
She's not that bad for me, so I can't complain. She turns on a black switch. She's like got a black switch somewhere in there. She's like,
dude, you
motherfucker,
missed
please.
It. You missed it in class today. She's like, security.
Security.
I would miss it when we said security.
Security? Oh my God.
I told you
she's got a black
where
switch.
Where was your recording? Where was your recording?
I wish I got it on
dude,
recording.
Dude, no. And then we started talking about football. Security. Dude, she went black as soon as we started talking about football. She's like, oh, dude, you see the 49ers? Oh my God, those guys suck.
I want to be in second hour.
I know, dude. Like,
she doesn't like fourth
because
hour.
Ryan is in that class.
Dude, swag bag. Biggest swag bag in our school.
Lorenzo,
he has the worst. Okay, I'm sorry. I like gauges on some people, but he has stupid ass gauges.
They're clear. They're fake.
They're clear, though.
They're fake. They're the fake ass gauges.
If you're gonna
gauges,
get
too.
Clear ones, then have them have something in them.
Okay.
Dude, no, they're the fake
like
ass
marbles,
gauges.
Like marbles.
Yeah, dude, no. They're the fake ass gauges.
Like mayonnaise?
Yeah. They're the fake ass gauges that you screw on, not the ones you stick through your ear.
Okay.
Not like freaking other Gil.
Let me see something.
Other girl. Oh my God, that was so nasty. Watching him walk through the halls and they're like this thick. I'm like, oh.
He's hot though.
Oh,
stress them.
Hey. Back to the horror subject. We even made a couple of jokes. So we were in forecast.
She got braces. So funny that you're gonna keep your mouth shut from other things.
I wouldn't do it.
Girl.
It was all in the car mentioned that.
Yeah, car cat, me.
I was.
Robatman.
Frau
Batman, my babe.
And then Car Cat's mom.
I wasn't
in
there.
The car. My mom is a boss.
So we were driving past some store. Because Car Cat's mom needed to pick up a few things.
And we were talking about the whore.
And how she got braces.
And Car Cat's mom says, "Oh, honey, that ain't gonna keep her mouth shut from other things. And here's the sacred demon with."
From other things.
And then we all just started laughing. Even my mom laughed.
Yeah,
that was
even Car Cat's mom started laughing.
No one likes this chick.
Nobody.
No one.
Yeah, and then she dates like these guys that are like 20 years older than her.
It's like, no,
and my mom,
don't do that.
My mom heard her talking to one of them on Skype once, and she got freaked out and was like, well, I don't want her, like showing you to some pedophile or something. And I'm just like,
dude, she masturbated in my room. She did. She was on a Skype call in my room, and she masturbated. She's like, here's my iPod. I'm like, what? She's like, listen to this music. I'm like, okay. So I'm laying there, staring up the ceiling, listening to this music, and then I start smelling something. I'm like, oh, and I only know that smell because I was staying over at her house once. She had her hand down her pants while she was sleeping, and the same exact smell came out. And I'm like,
you should really pause the recording.
Nope.
You should really pause the recording. We can go over there.
We can't pause. We can't pause on this one. Why? Go over where?
Okay, and I know
go over
you.
There, that way it's better light.
I know you've been noticing the fact that we've been all up on the whole hand holding thing. No, we're not dating.
We are not dating. We are not dating. They are not dating.
We're all single.
They are
we're not
dating.
We're all single.
We are
we're
not
just
dating.
We're just blowing cis over
they
here
are
being
not
stupid.
Dating.
None
so,
of us yeah. are dating each yeah. other.
We're all single. Yeah. We're all single and
we're
all
single
cis.
Loners over here.
And we're bro and cis. That's the only reason
you
we're holding hands.
You guys look like the black. Me and Brianna have the most light.
We're the black people.
You see a random face back here.
Oh yeah.
Ghost ass motherfucker.
Harpo.
Oh,
okay, so let's get to current events. Lil Wayne.
No current events, because it's a rant. We are going to rant our heart out.
What do you think?
Okay, then I'm going to rant about Lil Wayne. He's a dumbass! He's in the hospital right now
in
critical
condition
because he overdosed.
Lil Wayne's stupid.
And for every swag fag out there that likes him, I don't give a shit.
I like his older stuff, like Lollipop.
Lollipop is his best song.
Let's play that.
No copyright.
Dude, we're listening to a whole bunch of copyrighted songs.
Motherfucker.
Alright.
They're not that
all
song
the songs we're listening to, if you can hear them, go for their artists.
They're by...
Just don't...
put the link in the description.
Just keep talking.
So, back to the whore subject. Since, by the way,
the
we're all freshmen here.
Yeah, we're all freshmen.
Shocker, I know.
There
but
we go.
Yeah, we're
yeah,
freshmen.
Yeah, I may look
she
like a...
Children, just let her finish.
Yes, we are freshmen. What are
go from, I want to play some Lil Wayne.
Big
by
shocker.
Favorite.
High five.
You fucking. I love
that. Was terrible.
That's so Lil Wayne.
So, yeah, I know.
Let's play Little Rock.
Go ahead.
Okay. After, so, after,
yeah.
after the title of the song.
Go.
So, yeah, big shocker. We're all freshmen in high school. But blah, blah, blah. Anyways, since our freshman year in high school has started.
It's almost
I
over.
Swear, she's gone at least.
Pull it up a little more.
Three or four boyfriends.
Carefully.
I know.
Okay. So first one was Joey.
The fuck?
Second one was Matt. Third one,
this new guy, which
I saw him in the hallway. His name is Chris. He went into anime once.
Yeah.
I wasn't there that day.
That poor dude.
Oh, yeah.
He's
and
so,
so you know, this may not
he
look.
He's so innocent.
It may not look like it, but me, Car Cat, and the Sacred Demon are all. Like huge anime fans.
Oh yeah.
I'm getting
it may not look like it says the purple haired one, no joke.
You can't see your purple hair.
Sad. I look like a freaking Californian. Shut up, JJ.
I look like someone who just came from a punk rock No, I'm joking. I don't even know what I look like. I look like a gill and we're just gonna
dude,
leave
I
it
was
at.
Supposed to go to a concert last
redneck.
Night. Didn't go because I didn't
oh yeah.
We all know you're redneck. We all know
Harpo.
You're a redneck. One look at you and you
so,
know you're a redneck.
Here's Little Harpo.
No, this is also what we do on current events, since people rant about current events.
Oh my god, hurry up. Hurry
meteorite
up and do your
in
goddamn
Russia.
Current events.
Huh?
Meteorite in Russia.
Oh yeah!
A meteorite
let's
in Russia.
Let's start a rant about
here.
It, okay.
Feel us in.
The Ruski's got a meteorite. Okay.
There, we go.
Yay!
Yeah, that was our rant on
good
the...
Good job, guys!
We
have
to,
fun!
We have to start ranting about everybody, what everybody knows.
Thanks.
Cut for
dude,
Bieber.
We can just rant about whatever we want.
Cut for Bieber.
Okay.
Oh. Oh my god.
I've got so much to say about this.
Me too.
Cutting for Justin Bieber is the stupidest fucking things ever. He smoked weed. I could have counted down. Yeah, I could have counted down the days before he started. You have no right to cut yourself over that. Self-harm is extremely fucking stupid, and I sound like a hypocrite when I say this, but
I think the both of us are, if we were to say that. That's why I didn't say it.
It is
cutting yourself over a celebrity.
I will fucking murder you. Come here.
Whose fame is probably going to die out within the next year or so.
Dude, if Wiz Khalifa had fans, the moment he popped up...
Yeah.
Yeah, no. Dude. No.
Dude,
that's
the safest drug on the market, and they're gonna go and cut themselves over it?
Yeah, no, you guys are freaking out about one of probably the safest drugs on the planet. You guys are freaking out about the stupidest things. Just get over yourselves, and then... Yeah. One Direction fans, I've got a little shit to say. Telling people from... all-time low, and the fact that Mitch Lucker died from suicide silence, he was one of my fucking idols. And if you're gonna go tell his 5-year-old daughter to kill herself because her dad was a weak emo fag, you just need to get the fuck over yourself. And then when you ask why no one likes you, well, maybe you should look at it. Maybe look in a fucking mirror and find out. Because
this is why I said it's a good idea.
Because telling a 5-year-old girl who just lost her dad to go kill herself is not okay.
No, I admit some One Direction fans aren't loony. We're talking to the loony ones. Because, you know, what's her face? Christina and...
Rachel, Christina.
Mildred. They're not crazy.
And
Mildred. They're pretty chill.
Vanessa.
They're pretty chill.
Vanessa and Allison.
I miss Vanessa.
Mildred's sister.
Don't cry. Don't cry. Don't pull Lily in the middle of the band. That shit made me cry.
Lily is emotional.
Anyways.
Every single day I come up to her, hey,
like,
Lily.
I have seen...
What's wrong this time, Travis?
Anyways.
She's
I'm gonna join...
Attached.
No, it's not
Batman.
She's just jealous.
I've
seen...
In general.
I understand why Megan hates her now.
I have seen so many things on Twitter that have just made me to want to punch every One Direction fan, except for the non-loony ones that are my friends. I want to punch them in the face so hard they're hospitalized for a month.
Actually, in general. Of course, I'm not talking about everybody, but those of you out there who are into pop, which I can understand, that's your choice. I'm not saying, oh, pop is bad, all of us rockers need to gang up on pop people. No, I'm not saying
pop,
that at
she
all.
She can't do that.
If you guys want to listen to your own genre of music, in fact, if you want to listen to more than one genre of music, that's your choice. But there are people going around, whether it's One Direction, whether it's Justin Bieber, whether it's anybody of any pop music who decides to take things in their own hands, telling people who listen to rock to go die, that they're only Satanists or something like that, what is your problem? Something I want to specifically bring up. Some of you listening to us right now may know the the band
Disturbed.
Personally, one of my favorite bands, because they pulled me out of my depression. Just because one of their symbols has the Satanist star on there, or the Satanist like horns or whatever on it, does not mean that they're all just Satanists. And those of you who think that they are need to get your brain checked, because they're not. Yes, one of them may be a Satanist, and people think that it's so wrong to believe in what's supposedly the Antichrist, and it's your choice, but do not fucking go around telling people to go die just because they seem like Satanists, when you don't even know a fucking thing about the band.
Yell if you have to.
Turn up the volume!
It's okay.
Assertive!
I know, I love this stuff too.
No, but like, seriously,
of course, once again,
let her finish.
I'm not talking about everybody. I just want you guys to know that. I'm not talking about everybody. It's just those people who decide that they can take the role of God or something like that, or whatever you want to believe, and tell people like me and Frau Batman here to go kill ourselves just because we listen to Satanist bands or something like that. Just take a second look, please. Pull your head out of your ass for a minute and just take a second look.
I was dancing.
Dancing like me.
The band Disturbed pulled me out of my depression, and I think Black Veil Brides was the one who pulled Frau Batman out of her depression.
You have no idea how many bands have pulled me out of my depression. You don't know how far back into depression I went into when I heard that Mitch died. When I heard that Mitch had gotten into that car crash or that motorcycle accident and died, I cried myself to sleep, and I still do. Because of the shit that I see, that people tell his daughter to go kill herself, or people talk about that he purposely got into that motorcycle accident because he was a weak emo fat. You know what? You don't even know what the word emo means. It means that you're emotional. Everyone has fucking emotion, so just get over yourself. Emo is just slang, and it's fucking ridiculous.
Unless you want to be one of those pricks who thinks that people with emotions are just weak and they need to get over themselves. Okay, people, everybody is sensitive. Some more sensitive than others, and that is okay. Unless you want to be one of those emotionless pricks who are just dogs of the new media, which,
okay, I'm sorry.
Some is good, some is bad. But if you want to be an emotionless prick, dog of the new media, fine. Quit watching this video. Press that pause button and just go listen to something else that obviously we're offending you in some way. But still, let us.
Don't be here in the room. I'm sorry. No violence.
Let us be who we want to be and you be who you want to be. Hold on, I have one more thing to say.
Oh my god, hurry up. Will, if you would stop getting in the picture. I'm right here.
You're interrupting my frame.
Will you calm down?
Finish what you have to say, please. I want to say something before I forget.
You always have something you have thought of.
You're stupid.
Shut up.
Please enjoy.
God damn it, I lost my train of
Please thought. Enjoy ahead, this man. Pretty picture of a room.
Move your ass.
Ready? Go.
Okay. It's just.
I call next.
Me and her can both agree. Here, let me give you. Join hands! Anyways. See this hand? These are beautiful hands. Anyways. Let us be who we want to be. Whether that makes us emotional, whether this makes us sensitive. Whether this might even make us weak in your eyes, but we, as humans, are not perfect. We can not be perfect as human beings. We are not perfect.
Okay, so I found my train of thought again. You don't know how many times, you don't know how emotionally strong I have been. And how many times I've just hid myself from crying because I have a douchebag of an older brother that decides to call me a weak ass when I cry or when I do something. Last year for eighth grade, I cried the entire last day because I was losing people that I rarely ever get to see anymore. And I cried, and my brother went and asked my mom what was wrong. And she told him that I was upset because I was losing a lot of friends because they were going to different schools than I was. And my brother told me that I needed to get the fuck over it. You don't know how many times I've been told to get the fuck over something for crying because of my douchebag of a brother. You don't know how much I've held in because I can't cry because I'm scared that if I cry in front of anyone, I'm just gonna get called weak. And I hate being called weak. I hate being called anything.
Oh, something else I would like to bring up, just real quick. Bisexuals and homosexuals. People think that they can't be homosexual or they can't be bisexual because they're only going to get made fun of, or it's against their religion, or it's against their culture, or someone they love most doesn't approve of it. Well, I am sorry. I am deeply sorry if any of you get offended by this. But it's really not their issue to deal with.
It's something you're born with.
It's your personal choice. It can be something you're born with. It can be something that you choose by yourself. People, you do not have to be afraid of your
sexuality.
Yeah, your religion, your political views, your sexuality, anything like that, you don't have to be afraid of.
There will be a group of people that will accept you.
Yeah, exactly.
There's always that one.
There are people out there who will accept you for who you are.
There is always that one person who will be there for you and will accept you for who you are and be your savior. It may come later in your life or it may come earlier in your life. I didn't get that person until I was in fifth grade. But I have that person now, and she's still there. She's still there for me whenever I need it. And that makes me really happy that to know... It makes me really happy to know that I can have the very first friend I had in my life. I was bullied up until fifth grade, never having one friend. I went to a Catholic school in fourth grade, and they shunned you if you wore any sort of black at all.
And if you don't mind sharing, who was this one friend?
She's my best friend, Angel. I met her in fifth grade, and it was so funny how we met. She hung out with all guys, and she dissed one of her guy friends at lunch one day, and I was sitting near him, and I heard the diss, and I just started laughing, and we started talking, and we realized how much we had in common, and ever since then, she has been my best friend. She has helped me through so much. She has helped me with relationship advice. She's helped me with whenever I need to rant. She's helped me whenever I need to cry. She's been there. Because she's the one person I know that I can go to and I won't be called weak or I won't be called overly emotional when I cry.
And one more thing, just to add on to that. In sixth grade, I felt like I had nobody. Do you want to know how much I've held in, like Fro Batman? I called you Fro again.
That's
okay.
But anyways.
Fro. Sham!
Dude, I love Hisham.
We're gonna make you a profile picture like that.
Fro Batman.
Yeah, it's just Mark. Batman with a wow.
Mark.
If you remember, you had a Bob the Builder birthday.
When?
I had a Powerpuff Girls birthday.
That's awesome.
I didn't have a themed birthday till like seventh grade. Birthday.
You would not get off of it. You were like 5 years old, 5 years.
But
oh!
You want to pop the
coming on video.
I have my mom making a Scooby-Doo cake.
Guys.
Did you just remember that?
Yeah, I think we're going to get you a pop the cake.
Really, JJ?
Anyway.
Okay,
anyway.
But the thing is.
I'll be quiet this time.
The thing is. In sixth grade, I felt like I had nobody. I was bullied constantly, and I am bisexual. I will admit it. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid to admit it. I am bisexual.
Bisexuals have more acceptance than gays, though.
Exactly.
Even though the people are opening up, it's still kind of a touchy subject.
The four of us right here, except for Harpo, but we're still okay. We're still friends. The four of us right here.
Stop cussing the fuck out.
Are bisexual or gay, and we're not afraid to admit it. I can speak for everybody when I say that we're not afraid to admit it, and we have a straight friend, and we see that as perfectly fine.
So all you haters out there, all of us have to say this. Ready? One, two, three.
Fuck you!
I said fuck. Yeah, I said it in another language. No.
But anyways, do you guys want to hear my story? In sixth grade.
That's doing business.
Wait.
We gotta add a little bit of fun time into this.
I barely got to really talk.
In sixth grade. I was bullied. I was punched. I was scratched. I was kicked. Do you guys want to know what? For being bisexual. And you want to know what hurts the most? Physical pains go away. Mental pains stay with you. I was called a worthless butch. in sixth grade. And that really hurt. But I believe that everybody in our audience who is bisexual or homosexual or straight, it doesn't matter. I believe that you guys can stay strong.
Pansexuals.
Even then.
Any sexuality you are.
Yeah. Metrosexuals.
You don't asexual.
Oh, I love asexual people. They're so
You
cool.
don't have to be afraid of your sexuality. It's okay. I mean, we've all lived through that.
See? I have had.
I've been waiting patiently.
10 seconds.
10 seconds, my ass.
Just let Gil talk.
Hurry up,
I promise I'll let you talk after, okay? Pinky promise. If anyone interrupts, I'll slap him in the pit. All right. So, seventh grade. For being me, I had my very first girlfriend, and for being me, I got abused every day in. I know it sounds weird. God damn, turn that shit down! I know it sounds
just
weird.
Turn it off.
No, we're not taking it off.
I know it sounds really, really weird, but I was forced into having sex with a girl. Oh my god, a guy was forced into having sex. You never hear that. But I constantly got slapped. I got called a stupid fucking motherfucker, etc. You know, I got called a Nazi for being German. And then my head got bashed into a mirror like twice a month. Like, the mirror cracked once. That shit hurt. I have scars on my forehead from it. And it's because I thought I loved her that I stayed with her, honestly. And, you know, when I realized I didn't need her, I left her. I went for my second girlfriend, and I learned from her. Third girlfriend, all of them broke up with me, actually, honestly. I didn't break up with anybody. And now I'm single, and I'm perfectly fine. I mean, like, you know, no matter how much abuse you get, it will honestly get better. It's not gonna come quickly though. It will not come quickly. It will be probably the most long, arduous, painful wait you will ever experience. But it's worth it. Because once you find that right group of friends and motherfuckers that you wanna hang out with all the time, and they make you feel good, they make you smile and all that, you know, like, you feel good and like, you don't care what the rest of the world, like, what's happening with the rest of the world. Like, you're just so happy. The stage is yours.
Oh, okay. So, we're done with backstories, but I didn't get a chance to tell mine, bitch.
Go ahead.
Okay, so.
Tell your backstory, motherfucking
I'll show you how I met these guys. In seventh grade, when I moved out here, I had no friends. New different state, everything. I was lost. I didn't know what to do. Until the beginning of 7th grade, I found my first friend. He was actually my first best friend. And then half a year later... Are you kidding?
Come on. See how this is. Okay. I gotta get up for it. Yeah. Motherfucker.
And then half a year later, we stopped talking to each other for some reason. Maybe because of some stuff that happened in that half year that turned us away from each other. So I was lost for another month, until I found my second best friend. And then she brought me into this group of friends. Which 2 years has passed, and look at us now. Really close.
Thanks, and come to think, worst subject ever. Yet, that's how we met.
How I met everybody. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
I love Kayla. I miss her so much.
No. Funny thing is, how I met these motherfuckers, I was sitting on the girl, it's segregated in the lunchrooms.
Yeah, our school
last year. I was
sitting
on the girl's side because I didn't know no better. And I was sitting on the girl's side. And like this chick pulls me up, hey, let's hang out. I'm like, what the fuck is going on?
And then at lunch, after lunch, we'd go outside and I watched our friend Kayla, who was the one that pulled him up, skip over to him doing that. And I ran over to her and pulled her away and I'm just like, stop bothering the new kid.
Remember we were trying to get the twins in our group?
Yes.
Angel's so stupid.
I'm all like, yeah. But yeah,
I knew it wasn't gonna happen by the way they looked.
But one of them had a really big crush on me.
By the way they looked though, I knew they wouldn't hang out with us.
Oh yeah, dude, I knew right away they wouldn't hang out with us.
I can read people too easily.
Yeah.
I bet none of you actually expected me to be this retarded. Like when you first saw me, did you expect me to be this retarded?
Oh, I did.
Did you? See, at least she admits it. I didn't seem that retarded until you guys met me. I bleached my hair.
Dude, You want to know what I was thought of until I met Angel in fifth grade? The quiet loner kid in the back.
I was that one new kid with blonde hair.
See?
You had black hair when you
first came.
I know, but then I dyed it blonde like
I never got bullied. And the reason why is because I have charisma. I have a really big sense of charisma. Everybody likes me.
But that's also not a good thing at the same time.
I'm liked. I can be liked by anyone. I can be the best friend of the biggest swag fag out there. The thing is that the minute they hear the bands that I listen to or the fact that I'm bi or whatever, that's the minute they drop me. Because they don't like me.
Okay, so I've moved a lot. Oh, let's say that. More than everybody put together here.
Except for me. I moved around like an army family, too.
But, like, okay. Turn that shit down! I'll admit it. I'm a military brat. And I've moved a lot. And I've been accustomed to making friends because ever since I was little, you know, I've gotten used to moving to a new school and be like, hey, you're my friend now. But it's not always a good thing. I mean, I listen to every single type of music because parents are awesome. And they're like, here, listen to this. Oh, you like this? Do you like this? Do you like this? They gave me options and choices, which most parents don't do. They said, do you want to do this or do you want to do that? And they always said that. They never said, you're going to do this or you're going to do that. Unless I needed to do chores. But no, and then I got so many options and choices. So I listen to everything. I love everybody. This is why I'm a pansexual. But I love everybody. And I can easily make friends. I'm friends with almost everybody in the school except for... No, actually, no.
Yeah.
Friends with them, too. I'm friends with everybody in the school that knows me. And it's kind of weird. Because one minute I'm talking like a black person, the next minute I'm talking like the whitest kid on the street. Not even kidding. Like, I'll go from, hey, what's up, my nigga, to... Hi, guys. How are you today?
I'm fine and dandy. How are you?
Oh, I am just...
Glorious. Oh, my God. Let's talk about
Oh, my God.
Gossip.
No, Olivia. He's fabulous. He's fabulous.
Nobody can do it like that Orbit girl. Dude, I wanted to do it like that Orbit girl, but...
Oh, no, dude, but we were just, like, watching... We were just watching, medieval times. We were watching the knights, the present to the king. And Olivia and I were like, he's fabulous. It was so funny.
So he had Orbit.
His teeth were white as fuck, dude. Anyway...
I want somebody in this group to talk like the Orbit girl commercial.
I don't know how to do that.
If I could, I would.
Practice.
But yeah, back to what we were talking about earlier with rock bands, because that's what I wanted to say way earlier, and then everyone's like, hey, we're gonna interrupt this purple haired bitch.
I'm sorry,
no,
I just
but
I really
we said we were gonna stop in 30 minutes, fuck that shit.
Flip a table.
I've been doing
subscribe.
That the entire time, like, well, you guys kept interrupting me. I'm like,
I know, I could see him.
But back to rock, I listened to everything under the sun. Everything. I listen to, like, old classical music to nowadays fucking bullshit music that I hate so much, but I still listen to it. I listen to everything in between. I may have not heard of a few bands, but hey, I've listened to their genre, definitely. And, you know, it's kind of hard for me to understand the hate. Like, I can understand some hate, but I can't understand, like, all the hate, like, the hate that they were talking about, because I've never seen it, honestly. It's probably because I'm never on Twitter. I'm on Tumblr. I'm on the most friendly, fucked up, perverted place ever. It's not friendly for kids. Stay off Tumblr. No, I'm joking. But, oh, God damn it, Joey, I hate you. They got me addicted to Tumblr. I didn't say that. Anna. I didn't say that. I didn't admit it.
Anna and Joey.
But, yeah, I can't understand the hate, honestly. The only hate I can't understand is when a foreign exchange student comes into America, an income fucking... hardcore stupid Americans. Like, I love all Americans, but those ones, they just need to get their shit together a little bit. Like, I'm German. I'm natural born Deutschland over here. Ich bin Deutsch all the way. And like, 7th grade, I was constantly called a Nazi. I was actually legitimately shoved in a locker and stuck because they broke the lock. I'm like, I'm banging on the locker and everything. I couldn't get out. I was pushed in a trash can, shoved in a trash can, pushed into a toilet, had my head, like, dunked into a full sink. I got pushed down a flight of stairs And that got locked in the elevator in our school. Yeah, we had a... Nebraska had an elevator, what do you know?
What the fuck?
Yeah, Nebraska schools have an elevator! And the... Honestly, the only people I could trust was my friend Sierra and my math teacher. Surprising! Ironic. My gay... I swear he was gay. I swear to God he was gay. He had a wife, but I swear. When you come in with a skin-tight green shirt, a red boa, and ornaments hanging all over you... No.
God damn it, I'm sorry. I need to talk to her about mentioning that. But that wasn't his name, but that's what we called him.
Like, those were the only people I could trust. And that's the only hate I truly understand is discrimination like that. And just being discriminated for who you are. Because I was like that for an entire year of a relationship. I stayed with her for an entire year. Because I thought I loved her. No. We didn't have any love in that relationship. It was all lust, and even then, I didn't really...
Making noise, no one is a musician.
He can live without his music. God, where's the button? Turn it off. But...
I don't know, where's the power button?
There we go. Well, that's not it. I'm trying to turn it off. No, I'd rather listen to the next one. But seriously, and it wasn't even, it was one-sided, basically. It was one-sided love and one-sided lust. And yeah, of course I felt lust, but it wasn't like full-on lust. I admit, I kind of brought on most of it. But it's not like I really wanted all the harsh words to come after. I wanted love. And that's why I thought love was, because I never learned properly what love is. My parents act like best friends. It's kind of hard. They don't act like lovers. They act like best friends.
Trust me, I know. I practically live at your house.
And, oh my God, it was so hard to finally figure out what love is. It's when you and the other person can just sit there and hold each other and just talk. No need for that sex shit. That's not love. That's just you.
Damn it, JJ.
With hormones. That's not love. He has a password, doesn't he?
Okay. Wrong thing. On his phone, which we can get into just to take one.
What was it? And then, what else was it? Sorry.
What is this?
Where is that music coming from? That is so creepy.
Laptop?
Off. Wait. There we go.
God damn it! What's connected to the tablet?
Password.
I don't know.
Turn on the volume.
What is it I'm doing?
But God, no.
Back to what the fuck tablet.
What I was saying earlier was like, no matter how hard it may seem at the beginning, it will get better. It's gonna take a lot of time, but it will get better. It's just gonna be the world's longest wait, honestly. We're just blabbing now. We ain't even speaking normally, we just blabbing. Anyway, you got anything to say? You haven't talked this entire video. Just come rant. Get it out of your system. Spew it out. I'm chucking.
In Brooklyn.
No, that's how you say it, motherfucker.
Just sound good.
But, they both died and had an orgy in the bathroom with a black hooker. Anyway, let's take over.
Oh my God.
All right. Nope. Scoot your chair up here. We sitting up all close and shit. Well, then I'm sitting up all close. What's up, motherfuckers?
Oh, God damn it.
Now I can see the purple.
Anyway, do you have anything else to say?
Oh, I'm thinking. Leave me alone.
I kind of want to continue on the whore a little bit.
Go for it.
But this is kind of a long video.
Oh, well, they can get over it.
I'm kind of sick of being the only one that deals with her.
Then tell her to fuck off. I don't care if you want to wait until senior year. Tell her to fuck off now.
Like, the reason I'm waiting till senior year, though, is because, like, once it's senior year, and once I graduate, I'm out of there. I don't gotta see her again. I can just delete her number and block it. I don't gotta see her again. But if I tell her now, I gotta see her in every single class because she's in our core. It's fucking...
They are having a conversation.
They're having an orgy. Anyway...
No, they're having a serious conversation.
No, just let it be an orgy. Just let us think it's an orgy.
Okay,
it's an orgy. Leave it. And, another thing about this whore, I'm her only best friend, even though she talks to everybody.
Except for me.
Except for you. Even then, she's trying to talk to you again.
I know!
You know that.
I just ignore her.
Hi, Rivia. Oh, Rivia. Anyway, she talks to everybody. I'm like, if I'm your only friend, then why do you talk to every single... only best friend, sorry.
Don't smoke, kids.
But, like, she talks to everybody. She could easily make another friend. It's not that hard. I mean, for some people, sure, if you're shy. But even then, there's those certain open eyes. There's certain, like, people who are open as fuck. And they'll be like, hey, come hug me. But no, it's just, I don't know what to do without telling her to fuck off. Because I like the drama. I like it, honestly.
There's not much you can do.
At times, I like the drama because it gives me something to do other than sit there and pay attention to Bristow every day.
Oh, God, fuck her.
Bristow. Anyways. Bristow. I came up with the nickname Bristow.
Oh, so back to I figured something
Bitchtel?
Out.
Yeah.
Nice.
Miss Bitch.
I figured something out. So back to the whole thing with that he was talking about with trust. My trust issues are so bad. We may seem like the best of friends, brother-sister relationship, you know, even boyfriend-girlfriend relationship. He still doesn't know anything, everything about me. Because my trust...
I know a lot, though.
Because my trust issues are so bad.
She knows everything about me, though.
Because...
Well, almost everything. You don't know a few things. About my sex life. No,
I don't need to know those things.
But I like telling you everything.
I know.
I even like telling you when I gotta go piss. No, I'm joking.
Well, Dad,
no, but you don't know a few things about my past, either.
I'm used to it. You don't know.
I don't know a lot about your past.
Not really. The fact that the stuff that he does know is pretty horrifying, but the shit that he doesn't know is even more horrifying.
No, that wasn't a beer can.
It's Mountain Dew.
I promise.
We promise.
See, the can is too colorful. Anyway... And again, back to the trust issues, like, I have trust issues, but eventually I warm up. I'm one of those people that it takes a long time to warm up, but...
I've known him since the beginning of last year. I've known my friend Angel since fifth grade, and she still doesn't know, like, everything about my past. Mm-hmm. She knows as much as he knows.
Hi there, Olivia. And I honestly keep some things to myself because that's what I should do.
I'm just used to bottling everything up.
Same. Only I've gotten better at letting it out.
I haven't.
Actually, I think I've gotten a little worse this year, seeing as how, like, every time I have an emotional issue... Issue! Damn it, Anna! issue, I'll sit there and just let it bottle up till I burst.
Me too. It's about this long, but then I get shorter and shorter and shorter, and then I just burst on
But usually, like, I'm usually that happy-go-lucky motherfucker that smiles every day. I'm like, glücklich immer, you know. I'm always
it's
happy.
Immer glücklich. You gotta flip them. It's immer glücklich.
Immer glücklich?
Yeah.
Walter Ficker. But, I'm always happy. Sorry, I was raised in America. This kind of sucks. Bad kissing girl, was it win? But, no. But I would just... It's with my girl. No, not even then. With Jessie, I bottled it up. I didn't tell her anything. I didn't talk to her about anything. But with Angel, I let it all out, and I think I got to the point of which it was annoying, and that's why she left me. And then Grace left me because I bored her. She was I was done being her toy, and I got boring.
That's cause she a hoe.
She a hoe. And then Jesse's, I don't believe this fully, but I'm just gonna let it go. Jesse's dad broke us up because she's Wiccan. I mean, I guess he's overly Christian, and that could be a reason, because she's Wiccan, and he broke us up.
One thing about Wiccanism.
Keep going.
They aren't Satanist. We're just Satanism pagan. Is a type of paganism, but Wiccanism and Satanism are totally different thing.
And now that we're on the conversation of religion, no, we won't offend you. Calm your tits. But,
Jesus fucking Christ. Satanists worship the devil. We worship a goddess.
And a god,
but...
the horned one. Okay, I'm done.
You just don't hear much about him, so...
True.
You hear more about the goddesses.
Well, of course. Anyway. Honestly, I don't care what religion you are. We don't care what religion you are. No one in our group cares what religion you are. You can be fucking Satanist. Dude, a Satanist walks around our school and I'm like,
oh yeah, dude, nice. That's awesome.
No, but like, there's nothing wrong with it. As long as you're not trying to push your religion on another person, there's nothing wrong with your religion. So what if you believe in all bad things? So you're just a little pessimistic. No, I'm joking. But if it gives you a sense of hope, then just keep your religion. There's nothing wrong with it. There's nothing wrong with another person's religion, and I realize...
Pulling an angel here, I love this saying. Religion is like a dick. It's okay to have one, it's okay to be proud of one, but don't try to shove it down my throat. I'm shooting Brianna.
Do you need a hug?
No, I was shooting Brianna.
Do you need a hug? Fabulous. Do you need a hug? Give me a hug. That's what I thought. No, don't motorboat me with your titties!
What happened to my music?
We shut it off.
It got annoying.
Okay.
It kept being ghostly.
Yeah, and then it got really loud, and we were like, nope, we're done.
Because freaking...
So ladylike!
Remember?
Teapot.
What are you guys ranting about now?
Religion.
God damn it, don't rant about religion.
It's fine, dude. We're talking about how it's acceptable to have whatever religion you want.
Okay, good.
And then we just said Wiccanism isn't paid. Wicca isn't paid.
Oh my
Satanist.
God. Dude, there's going to be like, we should start.
We'll end it off at 54.
Yeah, end right.
No, just end it off at an hour, even.
Dare, watch this if you dare.
It's just us ranting in my back.
Hey, some people like to watch an hour-long rant.
Dude, I have.
I have to.
Russell will.
Go Panda.
Woo! Go Panda.
He gets the 52 minutes. Yeah!
When are we going to watch those freaking Urban Legends?
In a minute.
After.
No, we're not gonna watch the scary ones. Not
they
like,
don't need to be bouncing all over the place while we're on the trampoline.
Dude, like...
Continue.
So, like...
You can bring this over there.
Talking about bands and stuff, and then pulling the whole shut the fuck up about the whole Suicide Silence thing, you have no idea how bad I want to cry right now, but I'm not going to.
Don't you cry, otherwise I'll punch you in the tit, and then we'll all be happy.
Like, remember, think of Miss Bristol and fishnets and hooker
That's
heels.
Nasty!
Emily, do that.
No, I was about to say something. Calm the fuck down.
I thought she was, like, making a reaction to, like, the thought of that saggy old woman in, like, fishnets and
and a sexy bra that's a push-up bra, but her boobs are they're all like, no, all you see is, like...
Okay, I'm gonna ignore them.
Anyway.
So this is how her boobs look. Windmill.
So
no, I'm supposed to be done with a dick, motherfucker.
So the other day I was at Carcat's house.
Police. Barely. Don't be knocking the door like the police.
Z snap. I was just gonna sit on you, but okay.
Oh, okay.
Get your ass up.
The other day I was at Carcat's house and I was staying the night.
Alright. Here we go.
Cause I'm never home because I fucking hate my house. But
shut up, you have a jacket on.
Will you two shut up?
Well then here, you wanna take it, lady?
I'm good.
There you go, stop whining.
Okay. Anyways. I was at
this could be such a big video file to upload.
I was at Carcat's house the other day.
5 gigabytes.
And like no more. we were just being stupid and roughhousing and he like bit me.
Dude, we got so emotional.
And then like I was playing off that I was mad at him because I'm a fucking awesome actress. Not to boast or anything, but
boaster, keep going.
Shut up, Jingle.
Randy's a terrible actress.
Oh, I know!
Oh my god. Oh my god. This scared the shit out of me. All I see is Gil get up and something coming into the door. I'm like,
okay. Anyways. Shut up, JJ. We're. We were. Like, and so he bit me, and I was playing off that I was mad at him, and it got him to cry because he's overly emotional, which I'm totally
shut
cool
your
with.
Tits.
Shut up. You know you are. But he, like, so he was overly emotional about it, and he started crying. Then when he told me he was sorry, I flat out said,
get your fishnets, girl.
Do you have
a two-expanded fishnet?
Like,
that was not. That was on video shit.
The first thing I flat out said after the fifth time of him apologizing was, I don't deserve your sorry. I'm just a stupid fuck-up. Oh, that's fun and depression.
Excuse me?
And they, like, he kept telling me, and Harpo kept telling me that, like, I wasn't, and, like, I was just muttering, yes, I was.
I cuddled her until she stopped crying.
And
it's so fuzzy.
And, like, I was, I, like, I had fucking, I had cutting thoughts in my head, I had,
fuzzy.
I had,
I'm glad it took away the scissors.
I was tracing my wrists on how fast I could kill myself.
I'm gonna slap you.
And eventually Trish told Harpo, whatever the fuck you want to call her, told Carcat to start playing Black Veil Brides, who's like my favorite band in the world. And no, they are not chicks. Shut the fuck up. And about
yes, spine,
he played the song Perfect Weapons by them. Look it up, it's a fucking awesome song. Anyways, that I had just been crying.
Rihanna, she's like, that's tense.
And then how about Gil was
hold on, move.
Gil was like Saint Gil or Carcat or whatever the fuck
Gil.
You want to call
Gil.
It. Okay, Gil was singing through the song, and then about halfway through the song, I'd stop crying. God damn it! I'm in the middle of a talk.
Anna, you
I had
no. Come here.
I'd stop crying, and I was singing along with him.
You gotta put your shoulder into it. Shimmy.
And. Like, you guys really have no fucking idea how much those guys have saved my life. The first time I heard that band, I had been listening to them with a knife to my wrist. The second I had...
$5, okay.
The second... God damn it, JJ. The second I had been...
I'm trying to make the video more fun.
The second...
Okay, come here. Guys in the back, come on. Mark.
No.
Mark, I will step on your laptop.
So, the second... I had, like, the second I
fucking
heard,
head out the way.
I heard the very first song I heard by them was Savior, and I had
Jason, stop.
I had a knife to my wrist, getting ready to cut myself.
A wrist to your knife.
Oh, don't pee. You pee.
And,
I have to piss. Now,
I
shut
took,
up.
Go pee.
And oh, I set I'm it lazy. Down. Listening about halfway through that song, I had just set the knife down, and. That was the first time I'd ever heard those guys, and I realized that they were my saviors, and that they have done so much, just so much for me in the past, since they became a band.
Honestly, if we want to talk about bands that saved us or stopped us from doing something stupid, I know it's stereotypical German, but Rammstein's song, Wo bist du, it saved my ass. I was listening to that while we were having that emotional conversation about missing home.
Oh, I was listening to The Fray.
I know. I'm listening to other music. I have to turn your eyes off.
Good friend. That's a good band. I think everybody here should name a band and a specific song that you think really helped you.
Oh, that's going to be hard.
Oh, I know. The Fray. How to Save a Life.
You.
Disturb Inside the Fire.
You. Rammstein, Amor, und Wo bist du?
Black Veil Brides, Savior, and Sleeping with Sirens.
What?
No, I listed two. Just go.
He listed two.
Just keep going.
Or no. Scratch the sleeping with sirens. Pierce the veil, kissing in cars.
And another one of mine is the fray, if you found me.
That's another one from you?
It makes me cry every time I hear it.
Evanescence,
it
my immortal.
Really, oh, dude. Oh, I love that song.
So, we can say that Table Flippers Inc. is out.
And we're depressed.
We're not depressed.
Yeah. Wait, we gotta hear Harpo's song.
Harpo. Toby Keith, no, I'm joking.
Table Flippers!
Actually, it's called, the band is called Cutlass, and my favorite song by them is Sea of Faces.
Oh, so one more thing before we end this video.
Oh, dude, Red, Face the Machine or whatever.
Red.
I love Red.
Red, thank you, God. Anyways.
100 Ways to Hate My
So, another thing before we go, this is also about Black Soul Brides. I recently saw them in concert in January.
I'm not shaking my ass.
I was practically
in... What? You can't even hear any of us.
Right?
I hear our laughter and my yelling ass, man.
Yay. I was...
Black Soul Brides.
Those were the two guys I was with. I was probably in tears by the end of that concert.
Rat Tail.
Because I got to see my favorite band in the concert.
Rat Tail.
Will you stop messing with my rat tail?
Rat Tail!
Oh, you guys.
So, we wrapping up?
Oh, they're breaking.
Yeah, we
wrapping up. All right, guys. Kay.
Table flippers!
All right, tables and tables. Nope. Don't touch my shit. Don't touch my shit, motherfucker. Motherfucker, please. Please. Hey.
Bitches.
Anyway, everyone wave. I'll flip you later, tables and table hats, even though it's one gender. Bye.